Now, reports from Etiana District say a row has erupted between traders dealing in known food items and local government authorities over trading in markets across the district. The local authorities say the move is aimed at decongesting the markets to halt the spread of COVID-19. Private cyclists and border border operators have also been sternly warned on carrying passengers. Our correspondent has more.
Edward Muganga, the district information officer, says that as the positive cases of COVID-19 continue to rise, traders operating in these markets and the border border cyclists are to blame for spreading it.
Border. We have so far registered 10 border border people with the COVID-19, but they have kept on transporting people in the process. The third category, public markets. Many of them don't want to put on masks. And even those who are instructed to stay put in their masks don't do so. So that's why we have registered an escalating number of people infected by COVID-19.
In Mitiana Central Market, the biggest in the municipality, the district task force has resolved to using all possible means to decongest it. Muganga says they have passed a resolution that the traders work in shifts so that the market remains with few people.
The market in Mitiana Municipality, Central Division, is highly congested. And it has been a resolution of the District COVID-19 Task Force in Mitiana to decongest it using the police and the army to help us deter the number of people now coming in the market. We have also resolved to work with the management of that market, Mitiana Central Market, to see that we can have people work in shifts. If we work a full week, let even other group come in.
A visit to this market, we found most of the traders wearing masks and have water for washing hands at the entrance, although there is nobody enforcing it. Some traders, however, are still operating from outside the market. Yasin Dide, the deputy RDC, says that only food vendors must remain in the market and no trader should operate from outside. Dide says that if this fails, they'll be forced to use security agencies to help them enforce this directive.
No, we have noted that our market vendors, normally the food market vendors, have poor working conditions in the areas where they are working. However much we may love them to sleep within the markets as they operate, it may be a little hard because of certain hardships, certain things that require them to live there. So we have resolved that the municipal council takes over the responsibility of, one, seeing it that the hygiene is okay in the areas. In case they are still crowded and there are many, we may think of some places that we may put them and evacuate them from the normal working place and make sure that they work within the until the lockdown is over.
He admits there would be some challenges in the market, like poor sanitation, but the municipality must address them. This story was compiled by Luke Kajiri for the news in Mitiana District.